Star of the Sprite Horror Show, also called The Death of Esther Lee Klein. I'm Jörg Jason, this is my Twitter handle, and I will talk a bit about one of the oldest parts of writer, which unfortunately is below everything, and everything stands on top of it. And that's Esther Lee Klein and Esther Lee. So, what is SW Client? Well, SW Client is an early attempt at the observer pattern. This is how it's defined in Wikipedia. So, you want to have some way to communicate changes and events between things that are loosely coupled. One example in Writer would be you have the layout engine and the core engine, which is the old stuff. And then you have a human interface on top of it, and you don't want to have the core having to handle the uniparts. So you create events in the core, and you have the unipart listen and register the events and the objects at the core, and let the events then handle in the human interface. So that you have loose coupling, and the beauty would be the core, you don't have to know about your own. Alright. So much for the theory. Of course, we don't have one observer pattern in LibreOffice. I stopped counting. I just read for a listener, found a few, and you will find more if you look more thoroughly. But in the end, they should be really more the same, and the SW client SW modify is not particularly needed. For example, the SVT listener broadcaster can be pretty much the same, it's actually lower in the stack. But SW client and SW modifier had been much earlier. So this is what we have there. So you will find this comic if you Google for XKCD standards, and this is pretty much what happened in LibreOffice, and everyone tried to add just new implementations of this simpler stuff. So, how does SW modify and client work? You have an SW modifier, that's the stuff that you want to observe, that has events. In the example that I gave you with the writer call or layout engine on the one side, that would be the stuff that is in the layout engine. And then you have something that wants to know if things change, for example, new objects. And what then happens if there is an event? You send a message or an event and let it be handled by an event handler, which is called, the function is called modify all of these. And in Writer, the particular implementation has the event is two pool items and two naked pointers to pool items. So this is the implementation. And these clients are in a double linked list. So the SW modifier actually iterates over all its clients and notifies every one of them. This is problematic in many ways, and I will show you why in a bit, and this is the motivation to actually like move the notification of the observer pattern to some other implementation. No need to create yet another one, just you already have enough, and just move it to one of the existing ones. So one thing that happens is that you have this object, it calls some other client to it, and notifies about the event. This event triggers the callback there to handle something, which causes other events, which again, for example, cause something to happen at the original object. And one of the things that can happen in this handler is that there are other objects created that listen to the same object, which just fire an event. So you fire an event on an object, someone else listens to it, reacts to it, and causes another object to be added to the first one. Which is interesting, because you're iterating over this list of event handlers, and you don't know really where the new object is added. So sort of, you're not quite sure if it will receive the same event by which it was created, or if it will not. Also, you can remove listeners while handling an event. And what clients, for example, often do is they remove themselves from listening to a modifier while in the event handler. As the modifier's doubling list needs to be aware of that, because otherwise, if it just would have a pointer to the object that it's currently executing the event handler of, that object would be removed, so you couldn't go on in the doubling list. This causes the SW modifiers to have a list of all the iterators that are currently iterating over it, and then updating them, for example, one listener's removed, so one client. So you see it's already getting very complicated with all these objects tracking each other. Also, in Writer, almost everything is in the SW client. Because the easiest way to get this, to use this implementation is to derive from SW client, or derive from SW modifier. And SW modifier is actually an SW client. So, when you send, if you want to do anything essentially in Writer, you have to be derived from SW client, with some exceptions. But in general, if you want to interact with call objects, that's what you have to do. That's kind of unfortunate that you have this enforced by the architecture. Then we have this wonderful piece of code. I don't know if you can see this. Can you read that? This is what happens by default every time an SW client gets notified. And one of the things which are encouraging is it checks if it gets the message actually from the thing that thinks it is registered to, so it assumes that might not happen. But the real interesting part is this. So as I said, we have an SW modifier which sends events and clients that are listening to it. One of the things that might happen is that the modifier tells everyone, I'm actually dying right now. And the clients do not deregister or kill themselves. By default, what they do is they look up if the modifier is itself a client and where it is listening to. And if that's the case, they re-register at the one at the object that the original object is listening to. That's a very confusing and not at all obvious default behavior, which I assume causes lots of bugs. Yeah, hard to believe, but that's the case. So why am I telling you all of this? Well, with this linking of which again has things in double implicits, and they all point to the objects where they are registered in. You have essentially all of writer being one big macro, and you cannot like have a hierarchy or say let's do the layout here and then this calculate, and thus you cannot have logging or parallelization or multi-threading or anything like that, because essentially if you touch anything in writer, everything else might fall over. And that means the only thing you can lock is everything. So sometimes, I don't know if that's still overlooking Ruby, over some of the clients, but there is still, if you crack for it, looping Ruby in writer. If you don't know what looping Ruby is, this is looping Ruby. It's a toy that makes terms. And in writer, the meaning is a bit different. It's a counter that looks like if you're running around, if you're coming past the same piece of code for the 20th time, and if that happens, it just says, okay, I'm not going to lay out anymore, because obviously I'm running in circles. So it's not really deterministic if you run into these cases. The next thing is getRegistered in. You can call this function on the client, so the stuff that is listening to something. And because it's a double linked list, an intrinsic double linked list, it can only listen to one thing, which is not great. But more so, it means that you can actually ask, oh, what is the one thing that I'm listening to? And that returns an SW modifier, but almost everything in Python is an SW modifier of some kind. And if you prep for this, I try to remove a lot of those, but there are still 96 cases where someone says, oh yeah, I want to have the stuff that I'm registered to. And after that, I just do a static cast because I know what I'm registered to. I told you earlier that there's this confusing default behavior that if modifier dies, all its clients go to the object that the modifier was actually listening to. So there is no way really that you can assume that you can set a cast at one specific time. But we're doing that 96 times, so it's mostly okay. No, it's not. Also, the SW modifies, and so sometimes other classes are iterating over the clients manually. So they are not sending an event to everything, but they actually get the list of everything that is registered, and then say, oh yeah, I want to have only those that are of this specific type. Of course, because it's a double linked list, you still have to iterate over the whole list and just filter on those, which is performance wise not the best thing to do. And also, in a lot of cases, this is actually done just to get the first element of a specific type. So the modifier says, oh yeah, I know someone's listening to me that is of this specific type, and I want to get the instance. Ignoring that there might actually be multiple ones or none. This is essentially, and that this is of course just an SW client pointer, so from a client set here. And then there are random calls directly to the calling functions of the clients, which cause additional problems. Finally, in common problem with these event handlers is that you have the object and a listener, and somehow the listener forgets to pre-register and thereby causes memory to leak. And the wise writer of Romans of ancient times called this to be a feature, not a bug, and actually used the SW client modified thing, mostly for memory management, where you you just have a hacker that listens to the dying of the modifier and then the client puts itself to. So a lot of memory management and writers actually come this way. Finally, we have SW Pent, not a master anymore, but 6.6.1. As I told you, the clients are in a double list, which means you can only listen to one thing. And the solution was, well, if you want to listen to two things, the solution was that you have a tiny helper class that is a client and that forwards to the class that you actually want to trigger the event embedding. That doesn't make things more obvious or easy. That's actually very unhelpful to just see what actually is happening. And just to add one more horrible horror story, of course, because you're deriving from almost everything from SW client, you might actually get a credit diamond situation where you have an object that derives from two writer objects, and then you have the two listeners, and there's actually a code and writer that somehow assumes that there's just one way to be in a list or something, so that might break two. You can avoid that by doing virtual inheritance, and I'm sure that there's at least one case where we had to fix issues, but it's not really obvious, and what you put would be mostly obvious. So what I'm telling you here is SW client is a wonderful way to create surprises by web programming, which is not exactly what you want. So I wanted to kill the SW client. So what did I do? What's the first thing I did? Any guesses?
That was all done
SEO tools type thingy, which from the tools library, which is not very reliable and essentially re-implements the C++ type system. So I made that a bit more type safe with the template classes, and also added some aesthetic assets once we had C++ again. Then I created an SW broadcaster mixed in, which is essentially an SMT broadcaster so that you can easily use the new stuff when you gradually migrate away from the old mechanism. Then I removed this old SW depend once I had everything moved to these new listeners. And because the new listeners are not in a double linked list, they can listen to multiple parts, multiple objects, and that means that you don't need like an ugly workaround like that. But then I mostly cleared the SW client, SW modifier, core of writer. The next thing would be accessibility. Actually, there's not much left there, and the fun part will start with actually migrating the writer layout over. While doing this, unfortunately, there have been some regressions, and I would like to thank Cisco for immediately finding them, bisecting them, sticking them to my nose. Fixed a few of those. We took one commit back from 6.1. So these are on your master level. The last one was reported Friday, Saturday, and it wonderfully includes a crash. So stack trace, and I'm going to fix the remaining ones here, and then resolve. Go on. So, thanks for listening to my talk about the archaeology of Starfish Writer. Are there questions? Anyone? Wait a minute, my direction. Nothing? Okay, thank you.